Good morning, students. I'm Mansi Angni from Kernagar Secondary Municipal School, Bandra East. And today we are going to see the revision of the lesson number 10, Urbanization. First of all, before starting the lecture, it is today 1st of Jan and a happy new year to all dear students. And now we'll start with the lecture. So this lesson you must have already completed. Just a revision part we are going to take of the lesson number 10, urbanization. So here you can see on the screen, what actually is the urbanization? You can see here there is a lot of houses, they are congested, they are close to each other. So this is what this picture is somehow related with urbanization. So let's try to understand in this lesson, what is urbanization? Now, the first thing which is given on your page number 75, that is the can you tell. Now, this thing we are going to take in short. This is a dialogue between a farmer. Okay, the farmer's name is Tatya and his son Suresh. Okay, the Suresh is an educated person and farmer is there. And they are having a conversation. So, this is related with your lesson. So, we are going to take this particular thing in a short. Now, this Tatya is saying that, Suresh, I will come late to the field today. You go ahead. Okay, now there is a conversation. We are not going to read out everything, whatever is there in the conversation. Now, here the father, Tatya, he is a farmer and Suresh is also there. And Suresh is telling that, I'm going to come little bit. Okay, he's going to come over there and Suresh is telling that he will go in the factory for the work. So he want to adjust both the thing as well because he want to help his father also in the farming as well as he want to go in the factory. So this is what is there in that particular lesson. So what we can understand is that with the farming, the people are also attracted to the allied occupation or the occupations which are there available in their nearby places. So this story or this particular dialogue is somehow related with the lesson and that is why it is given in your first page. Now let's move to the geographical explanation what is given in this particular dialogue. So let's move to the next slide. Okay, this is what a urbanization means. Now you will notice that because of the factory, near the village, the occupation of the people of the village has started changing. Now the people understand that a lot of works are there apart from the agriculture and to get a good life or to get a standard life or to earn a more money, people are attracted towards this other job. More and more people from outside comes and start living in the village. Transport, hotels, restaurant, masses, retail shops and medical services, etc. start developing. As the result, the basic structure of the village start changing. Okay, when the previously it is a small village, okay, then the people start coming over there. Once any of the factories start, then the people start the businesses to provide facilities for the people who are coming in to work in that factories. For example, the restaurants are started, masses are started, then retail shops are started. Medical services are started and in this way, slowly, slowly the development takes place. Looking at our country, agriculture is the main occupation. Okay, everyone knows that India's main occupation is the agriculture in the rural area. Rural means in the village area. Agriculture and its allied occupations are being followed since time immemorial. So allied occupation means the occupations which are based on this agriculture, animal husbandry, dairy, and food production, all these occupations which are there, which are related to the agriculture. So they are going on from a lot of time or a time which we don't know. But now various industries have started coming up in the rural areas. All these industries have started coming up. For example, the factories, mills, energy plants, multi-purpose projects, etc. people come from the surrounding region to work here, and thus the population of the villages increases. Now here in this slide, you can see the point, okay? More than 75% engaged in the non-agricultural work. And this is what actually happens. When these factories are set up in the villages, more and more people from the nearby also villages, they come and settle over there. To fulfill their needs, other services also develop, like medical facilities, then food, hospital, recreation, etc. Consequently, the extent of the village grows and the form of earlier villages changes. And this is what actually happens. First, the village, how it is, then afterwards it's developed, and then the whole picture of that village changes. The Gram Panchayat providing public services to the village gives away to the municipal council or municipal corporation. When it is a very small village, then you can see what is the running body over there is the Gram Panchayat. So Gram Panchayat is responsible for the development of the small village. And afterwards, when the number is increased, when the population is more than 5,000, you can see here in the screen, and when the density more than 400 person per square kilometer, then what happens? The running of the whole village goes into the hand of municipal council or municipal corporation. These bodies provide the different basis services to the citizens. Okay, whatever basic services which are there, then these are looked after or handled by municipal corporation. Like drinking water is there, then roads, transportation is there, then sewage network, street lighting, everything it is looked by the municipal corporation. Besides this, the other facilities like town planning, recreation facilities, then tourist places, parks, etc. also need to be developed. When the small village turns into a big town and a city, then lot of things are made in terms of development. Now, page number 76, you can see here whatever the explanation is given that you can see on the slide. See, in 1961, the Census of India has decided to define urban on the basis of the following criteria. So these are the criteria which actually tells that what are the urban and what is the rural places. So what things comes under this urban or the term under urbanization? Now, first point is that more than 75% of the male working population should be engaged in non-agricultural occupation. So when more than 75% people are engaged in non-agricultural work, that is apart from the agriculture, they are going into the factories, they are going into the companies, means they are getting the money out of those sources which are available. That means the sources are more to get the money or to earn the livelihood. Now, next point is that this is one criteria to define the urbanization. Next point is the population of the settlement should be more than 5,000. Okay, now when a small place is there and a people cannot live isolated, people have to be live into the group. So people are living right from the ancient period, people are living in a group. So first few families are only coming together, then they construct the houses nearby, then this gives rise to the group. Then it little bit more people comes over there. Then it gives rise to a small village. And then after the factories or after the companies are set up in that particular place, the whole scene is changing. And then the people started coming from the nearby villages. They come over there to seek a job into those particular factories and companies or mills. And then slowly, slowly the population goes on increasing. And then the population becomes more than 5,000. So this is also one criteria to define the urban area. Next is third point. The population density of the settlement should be more than 400 person per square kilometers. Now, what should be the density? Density should be more than 400 person per square kilometer. Means what? The places or the houses should be near to each other, and per square kilometer, the people should be 400. And that is how you will find that the houses are constructed to each other. You can see a little bit congested area. So this is what you means, you can understand that this particular place is turning or developing or turning into a urban area. So this we have seen in this particular slide. Let's move forward. Page number 76. There is one activity. Try this. Now, there is one table given. In that table, years are given, an urban population percentage is given, and number of urban settlements are given. Now, let's see this. Let's try to understand this. Using the statistical information given in the table below, what you have to do is there here, you have to draw a line graph of the percentage of urban population using the computer, or you can draw it freehand. Discuss the term of urbanization after studying the graph and write the conclusion about the urbanization in our country from 1961 to 2011 in your own words. So this is what little bit we are going to discuss. Now what you can see, okay, you have to draw the line graph of this, that you can do it on your own. Now we are going to discuss this table little bit. Now what is this given here? Now see the geographical explanation which is given, which is related to this particular table. What the table tells us? Now the data is provided from the 1961 census counting is done, population counting, till 2011. This was the last population count. And after that, actually, it was in 2020. Then the population counting was not done because of the widespread or because of the epidemic of coronavirus. So this was the last data we are having till 2011, because they used to do the census after 10 years. So you can see here the 10 years difference is there. So the population counting census is done after every 10 years. But now, due to this particular situation, due to COVID virus widespread, there is a little change in the 10 years. So let's first try to understand this. Talking of the urbanization in India, the urban population has been increasing constantly from 1961 to 2011. Now this is related only to the urban population. Here rural population is not included. So what we have to study is that from 1961, how the population is changing till 2011, and it is on the increasing level. From 1961 to 1981, this growth was around 5.5%. Okay, you can see here from 1961 to 1981, the growth was less. It was just 5.5% only. But from 1981 to 2011, if you see 1981 till 2011, this growth was around 13.73%. So here each and every year you can see 1961, it was 17.79%. Then 1971, it was 19.11. Then 1981, it was 23.34. So no more, you can see not much difference is there till 81. And from there, you can see there is a difference, that is 13.73%. This means that the urban population is increasing rapidly in India. So this gives us an idea how the urban population is increasing rapidly. Urbanization occurs because of the many reasons. Now, there are a lot of reasons for this urbanization to occur. There are also good effects, there are also bad effects. So we are going to see that in the next part of the lesson. So first we'll see, we will study some of the main reasons. Now, what are the reasons which are responsible for this urbanization? Let's move to the next slide. Now, page number 76. The first reason is industrialization. Now, you can see here on this slide what pictures are given over there. Companies, okay, the factories, those are developed nearby places. And this is what is called as the industrialization. The industries are developed. The development and concentration of the industries in the region is a factor contributing towards the urbanization. As I told you previously, when these factories are set up, people go there to seek a job. Increase in the industries leads to the increase in the hope of the people who are attracted towards these industries. When these industries are there, people understand that there are good scope for earning the money. And everyone wants to earn the more money and wants to improve the standard of living. So apart from the agriculture, they like to go into these factories or to go into these industries to earn money. Who are attracted towards this industry from surrounding area? This increases the speed of urbanization. In the 19th century, Mumbai grew rapidly because of the textile mill started on the large scale in Mumbai. Now, in the 19th century, before 19th century, the picture of Mumbai was totally different. And from 19th century, Mumbai, there was a rapid change because a lot of those textile mills were started. You must have heard about Gilney and all that. So this textile mill started. And when this textile mill started, lot of the people from the nearby villages, they started getting jobs in this mill. They started getting earning more money. So that is why this mill attracted the people, and that is how the population of Mumbai started changing. Many villages, which was originally a fishing villages, okay, which was very originally was only known for the fishing or koliwadas, became the part of Mumbai metropolitan areas because of industrialization and urbanization. Only in the coastal areas, only fishing was done, and they were known as koliwadas. You must have heard now also, you can find a lot of koliwadas are there. But there, not only the work of fishing is done, but the factories are developed over there, industries are developed over there. So people from nearby villages have come and settled, and that's why the population of these koliwadas also have increased. So this is one reason for the urbanization. What we have seen is industrialization. When these industries are set up, it attracts the nearby people to come and stay over there, and that is how the population is also increasing. When the population is increasing, also the other facilities are there, basic facilities like hospitals, schools, then basic amenities which are there, which are needed for the people's development, also started increasing, hotels and all. So this is also one reason, main reason for urbanization. Now there is one more reason for urbanization, and that is called as a trade. So trade we have already learned in lesson number 9, and we have seen everything about the trade in detail. Okay, what you can see here in the slide is the trade, and what is that related to the trade is the type of advertisement, as also buying and selling. So this is what we have learned. The term buying and selling is related with the, it's called as a trade. So we have learned it previously. Now how this trade is also one reason for urbanization, that we are going to see. A place in a region is sometimes favorable in terms of transport, loading, unloading and storage of food. This leads the development of trade and related services. Now sometimes what happens, some places there, okay, so it will be very good for in terms of transport. Now, in terms of transport, the hilly regions which are there, they are not favorable for the transport. But wherever the plain areas are there, or you can see here Mumbai area, you know, Vashi site and all. So there you can see the godowns of, or you can see wholesale markets are there. So where the transportation is favorable, those particular places are also favorable or also the reason for the urbanization. Now, previously, New Mumbai site which was there, now that was not so congested because there were no people were staying over there in that place apart from Mumbai suburban. So slowly, slowly, what had started in a New Mumbai site, okay, that place Vashi is there. It's famous for the wholesale market. So the people started coming over there, which is having a good transport facility. Then the people started getting jobs when the companies, industries started in that particular places. So people started coming and residing over there. This is also related with the urbanization. Now, which facilities are also there related with this, like business complexes, banks, credit societies, go downs, cold storage, houses, etc. start growing. Okay, now which things are growing? Business complexes started growing, then banks started growing, then credit societies, go downs, as I told you, I gave you the example, then cold storages. So this, all the things started growing. That particular place is also turns into urban area. For example, one more example they have given in your book, and that is regarding with the Nagpur. Now, Nagpur in India is centrally located in India. Okay, now Nagpur, which is there, that is Maharashtra, it is that Nagpur place is centrally located. Now, urbanization started increasing here because this location facilitated trade. Now, since the Nagpur is centrally located, that's why it is easy for all the surrounding places which are near to Nagpur to deal in a trade with the Nagpur. Oh, that is why this is like, you know, what you can say, it facilitated the trade in the Nagpur, and that is why the Nagpur is developed. So this is related like how the trade is also involved in this, or how the trade is also one reason for urbanization. So we have seen industrialization, how it is related with urbanization, as well as we have seen trade, how it is related with urbanization. Now, let's go to the another slide. Now, you can see here mechanization and technology. Now, next paragraph is related with mechanization, the use of machines and the technology. So, you can see here in the slide. Now, previously, how the farming was done, more and more labor work was there in the village, still in that type of farming is done. Okay, more people are involved, or more labor work is involved in the farming. Now what happened, you can see here the machines have taken place in the labor. Now, whatever machine can do that particular work, for example, if the labors were 20 to 50 labors are needed. So that work is done by one machine. So you can see here cutting and also filling into the trucks and all, everything it is done by one machine. And lot of machines have come, new type of machines have come. So this is called as the mechanization and technology. We can see a lot of advantages of mechanization and technology in various fields. So in the various fields, lot of uses we can see, lot of advantages we can see of this machine. Both are helpful to urbanization too. In the recent decade, the use of technology has also increased in the agriculture. In the recent period, in the recent time, the use of these machines have also increased in the agriculture. Mechanization also increased in the rural areas. Agriculture is done with the help of machines on the large scale these days. Now, you must have seen in the rural areas, though they don't have a big machinery, at least they will go for the tractor or the machineries which are used for harvesting, cutting. So this small machineries also they are using. And because of that, what happened? The manpower employed in the agriculture became devoid of agricultural work. And because of this, what happened? The people which used to get the jobs in agriculture, used to depend on the agriculture. They don't have their own farms. So they used to go into the nearby places for doing this agricultural work. From there, they were getting money out of it. Now, since the technology or since the machine has taken the place of this manpower, they are not getting jobs into this farm. So because of that, what happens? This working class comes to the city to look for the work. Now these people have to do something to survive. So what they are doing, apart from this agriculture, they started moving to the places where the jobs are there. If the jobs are not there in their own villages, they started shifting from that place. So they go to the places where this particular urban areas are there and where they can get a job. As a result, the urban population started increasing. So people from nearby villages, they come to the village where there are the jobs in the companies and factories. And this is also one reason for urbanization. So industrialization is one reason, trade is also one reason, and mechanization and technology, it is also one reason which is responsible for the development or responsible for urbanization. Now till here we have seen, we'll go to the next slide. And because of this, what happened, you can see here in the slide that is an increasing in the urban population. If you see in the slide, this is just like a picture of Mumbai, you will not find a place to live. You know, you must have seen in the picture itself how congested is the place. You will not find the greenery, you will not find the trees over there. So that part we are going to see in the next part of the lesson, what are the adverse effects of this urbanization that is also there. But you can see the places have become so much congested. So let's move to the next slide. Okay, let's move to the next slide. Now next is regarding the transport and communication. In the region where transport facilities like road and railways develop, the urbanization of small rural settlement occurs rapidly. Okay, now you must have seen small villages are there. But there the companies are not set up. There the, the factories are not set up. So what is the other source for those people to get the earning or to get the money? But the different thing is also responsible for that. And that is transport and communication. Some places are very famous. They became very famous. They were very small villages, not known by anybody. But they became famous for when this transport and communication facilities were introduced in that particular place. For example, after the development of Konkan Railway, many villages like Savardhe, that is from the district Ratnagiri, lying closest to its proximity, having started urbanizing. Now you can see here, this is the Savardhe station. Okay, this is in Konkan area, that is in Sindhudurga, Ratnagiri. Okay, so in Ratnagiri area, this Savardhe was not known by anyone. It is a small village, okay, not developed. Or you can say there are no businesses in that place, no companies in that place. The people are like dependent on the agriculture. But how this place become very famous? Okay, small village from Ratnagiri, how it became very famous? When the Konkan Railway started, people came to know about the station. Okay, people like to settle over here because of the proximity. So that is why the urbanization started. Convergence of important rail route. Now important rail routes are there wherever there is a junction or wherever there is a conversion. So those places have also developed. Okay, those places have also developed. You can see here next slide, Busawar is there. You will hear this Busawar name junction, Busawar junction everywhere. Because what happened, it is a junction place. And more railway routes are connected to this particular place. So this Busawar also became very famous. This is from Jalgaon district. And because of this Busawar, as it was very famous, as many rail routes are connected over here, people can move to their native places very fast. So what happened because of that, nearby Savardhe place or nearby Busawar place, the urbanization started. People started coming over there and people started staying over there. So this was also one factor, like industrialization. See here, industries are not there. Here, businesses are not developed. Okay, like trade routes are also not much. But what is there here? Here it is a railway junctions are there in the Savardey and Busavar, and these places became very famous. So the urbanization started taking place in this particular areas. Now this was what we have seen in the transport and communication, how transport and communication is one of the reason or is one of the factor responsible for urbanization. Now let's move to the another factor, page number 77. Now here one more activity is given: obtain information regarding the development of settlement, villages, town, etc. located on the main transport route in your surrounding at in a last five years. So you must have heard also, because of the railways, starting of the railways, so places are known. That information you have to get, but this is an activity part. Now let's come to the next factor, that is the migration. The next region which is responsible for urbanization, and that is migration. Now here in the slide you can see the people are shifting from one place to another. They are having the luggage in their hand. So this is called as migrating or migration. Now what is this migration? Now migration is a major factor affecting urbanization. This is the main factor, or the bigger factor, or the major factor which is affecting the urbanization. This migration can be short term or long term or permanent. So this migration, people sometimes, you will find a lot of migration is people are migrated from other places and they are shifting into the places or the urban areas which are nearby. So this migration, sometimes what happens, people just go from one village to another village where the jobs are there. Then the people, when they find that it is very difficult for them to travel from one place to another, then what they do, they settle over there. Once they are used to that particular life or the life of the urban area, then no person wants to go again and stay into the, go back in the village and stay over there. So that time the migration becomes permanent or a long term. So this is called as sometimes the migration is short term, or sometimes the migration is long term or permanent. Migration occurs from rural to rural area also, and rural to urban area, or urban to urban area. So see how the migrations are occurring. From small village to bigger village, okay? From bigger village to the cities, which are not that developed, and from cities to the metro areas. So in this terms, the migrations are occurring. The attraction of the high standard of life also has resulted in the increases in migratory. Now, the attraction towards the high standard of life. Now in Mumbai, in Pune, you will find there is a standard of life or standard of living is bit high. So some people like that type of living. They want to enjoy this type of living, and that is how to get all the amenities, to get all the facilities which are available into this metro places. The people from nearby small cities, they also come into the metro places to stay over there, and this also gives rise to the urbanization. For example, the migration occurring cities like Mumbai, Pune, from other parts of India. Now, in Mumbai only, you must have seen lot of people are coming from the nearby cities also. Okay, you will find everyone here, all people, they are coming from every part of India. You will find here Marathi people. You will find here the people from UP, Bihar. You will find here the people from everywhere. You know, everywhere people are coming here, because in Mumbai, the standard of living is very high. And people like to come over there. People, of course, other factors are also responsible for that. Industrialization is responsible for that. Trade is responsible for that. Mechanization and technology is responsible for that. Transport and communication. So when you find everything in one particular place in those small cities turns into metros. So this is what has happened in the place of Mumbai, how the Mumbai has turned into a metro. Now, we have seen today this, what you can say, the reasons for urbanization. We have seen urbanization, we have seen the reasons for urbanization. Next is the effect of urbanization, in that advantages of urbanization is also there, and disadvantages of urbanization is also there. Now, what effect of urbanization is there? Because of urbanization, the characteristics of the region changes. Then what happens? We can experience the difference of the land use. For example, the land under agriculture is used for the residential purpose. Okay, the land under residential purpose is used for the factory purpose. So these all things are there which are related with the effect of urbanization. Now, this effect of urbanization, advantages and disadvantages, we are going to see in the next lecture. So before going to that, so we'll revise what we have seen today. Now, we have started with the term urbanization. Okay, in this urbanization, we have seen the first, there is a dialogue which is shared in your textbook. So what the dialogue is related and how it is related with the urbanization. Next, we have seen what actually the urbanization means and what are the basic criteria for the urbanization. How we can see that the village is or the city is turned in, means it became an urban place. So what criteria are there, that also we have seen. That is, more than 75% of the people should be engaged in non-agricultural work, and then the population should be more than 5,000, the density more than 400% per square kilometer. So this we have seen the criteria also, and we have seen it in detail, as well as we have seen the population counting table and activity also given for you based on this to draw the line graph. Then what we have learned from this particular thing is that we have learned about the table, and we have learned how the change of population was there in 1961 to 1981, 5.5%, and then how it was increased from 1991 to 2011, how there was a rapid change in the population. So this was also one factor. Now then, so we started with the reasons for urbanization, and that is one reason we have seen. Urbanization. This was also one reason. Then what else we have seen the next reason is the trade. Okay, the in trade, how this was one reason which was very much responsible for the urbanization, that is buying and selling, which is related, and the trade, how it is related to the urbanization. When the trades are developed in that particular place, so people start coming and living over there. Then we have seen the use of mechanization and technology is one of factor which is responsible for urbanization. When the machines are replaced by the human being or by the labor power, what the people will do to survive, they have to go to the nearby places to take their job. And this is also one reason which is responsible for urbanization. Next, what we have seen, because of this, there is an increase in the urban population which gives rise to the urbanization. And transport and communication, we have seen how it is responsible, how the small places which becomes known to the people when there is a devoid of when there is a devoid of business areas, when there is a devoid of what you can say is that factories and companies, even then also these places become important, or these places where the population increases. And the other factor, a different factor, that is transport and communication, which is also responsible apart from industrialization and trade, which is developed, which is related with this urbanization. Next, we have seen this example, it is given in your textbook. It is regarding that Savardhe place from Ratnagiri and also the Bhusawal junction. And the last part, what we have seen in today's lecture, and that is the migration, how the people are migrating, and the migration is done from village to village also, that is from rural to rural area. Sometimes the migration is done from the ruler to the city areas, and from there the urban to urban areas, means from the small cities to the metros. So this is how the migration is done. So this is related with the urbanization. And in the next part, we are going to see what are the effects of urbanization, advantages and disadvantages of urbanization. So this is for today's lecture. Hope you must have understood the lesson urbanization. This was the revision part of it. So thank you, students. Hello, ma'am.
Hello, teacher.
Hello.